Hello friends, welcome again, and this is my new project, Heart Disease Prediction System, and I have developed this project in Python, Django and MySQL. The version for the Python I am using is the Python version 3 and the Django version is 2 and the MySQL version is 5.6. For connecting the Python Django with MySQL, I am using the PyMySQL and the MySQL connector, which you will get easily from the MySQL.org website. Even if you are using the pip, then you can install the PyMySQL with pip. Even I will provide you the requirements.txt. You can install the requirements.txt using the pip-r command, and all of the library which is needed for running this project will be installed automatically on your system, right? So these all are the technologies I am using. For front-end development, I am using the HTML, CSS and JavaScript. Some of the jQuery library also I have used, like you are seeing the slider running on the home page. I'm using jQuery for that. For creating charts, I'm using the chart.js libraries. Menu, and for creating date calendars, I'm using the jQuery libraries. So for many of the things, I'm using the jQuery libraries. For many of the animations, for creating sliders, for form validations, for creating data tables, I have used jQuery plugins. Okay, so these all technologies I have used for developing this project, Heart Disease Prediction System. And this is a multi-algorithm heart disease prediction system. Multi-algorithm means I have implemented many of the algorithm inside this project for predicting the heart disease according to your data. You will provide some of the data inside the project, and after that, that algorithm will predict that you are suffered from heart disease or not, right? So there are six algorithm I have used in this project, right? The first one is the logistic regression. The second one is the random forest. The third one is the nav-based. The fourth one is the SVM, KNN, and the decision tree. So these six algorithms I have used inside this project, okay, for predicting the things, right? You will get all of the algorithms output there inside the system, right? So let's start with the functionality go through, right? So this is the homepage of the project. You can see this is a simple SOAR homepage, right? And this is a totally contents are static. Nothing is dynamic. Nothing is coming from the database on this page, right? This is about, and it's normally about a speech. And if you want to change the content, then you can directly do it from the HTML. This is the login from where admin will be able to log in and perform certain operations, right? This is a contact us page, and this is a static contact us page, but this is a real Google map. You can see this is the real Google map, but I have not added the API key of the Google. That's why it's showing that for developing purpose only, right? So I'm going to log in. So this is the totally managed by the SQL, means your user ID and password will be verified from the SQL database, and after that you will be able to log inside the system. So the user is admin and the password is test. So once you log inside the system, oh, sorry, I think I have changed the password. This is a test one, right? Let me change the password first. Test. So the password will be test, right? So this is the home page of the project. Already explained you. This is the about project, right? Already explained. This is the dashboard, right? So what the admin can perform, admin can upload the file. Upload the file for what file? The admin will upload, right? So because you know there will be a different types of data sets, right? There will be a different data set sources, right? You can upload those data set here, and on those data set you can check your predictions, right? So there is a provisioning here that you can upload multiple data sets inside the system, and after that you can analyze, you can predict your heart disease on those data set, right? So this is the upload files. This is the upload files from where you need to heart name means upload heart file, and this one data set name. This will be the data set name and the file and the description, right? This is the next one, the files report, right? So all of the, currently I have only a single file. I have downloaded it from the Kaggle data set, right? So if you have other data sets, then you can also upload it, and you can check the data, you can analyze the data, you can perform the predictions on those data, right? So there are four buttons here: view data, delete, prediction and analysis. So this all four data is working, right? So four link is working, right? So click on the view data. Once you click on the view data, then in this you will be able to get all of the CSV file data in here, right? So this all data is coming from the CSV file, right? So there are 31 pages, means there are totally 303 records. So I am performing the prediction of the 303 records, right? So these are the data. So you can analyze the data right here, right? You can search the data, right? Even you can export the data in CSV format. You can export the data into the Excel format. You can print the data into the PDF, and you can even print it also, right? So these all buttons are working. There are the pagination here, right? You can paginate here. You can see the pagination is working fine. Even this record is also working fine. You can search here, right? So like I am searching 178. So all of the records which belong to 178 will be displayed here, right? So this is the files report, right? So view data already explained to you. This is a delete. Once you click on the delete, then all of the file data will be deleted from the database, right? And you will not be accessing it again. So don't delete it if you uploaded the valid data, right? This is the prediction and this is analysis, right? So prediction I will explain you at the last. This is the analysis, right? So once you click on the analysis, you will get the analysis of those data, right? Means what is the type of the data, what is the data shape, means there are 303 rows and 14 columns. What is the unique target values, means there will be a target, right? If you download any of the prediction data sets, then there is a target, then there is a 1 and 0, right? It's not 10, it's a 1 and 0. Percentage of patient without heart disease, means how many percentage, means how many target is 1, then there is a 45%. Percentage of patient, it's a I think there is a spelling mistake, but you can modify it, right? With heart problems, this is the 54%, right? So this is some of the information which we are getting from the data. This is the pie chart, where you can get the records, means what is the without heart problem and with heart problem. Red is the with heart problem and green is the without heart problem, right? Even what is the percentage of the gender, means how many males is suffered from the heart problem, how many females are suffered from the heart problem, right? Even these are the few columns, this is the top five columns, these are the five random columns, right? Data descriptions here, descriptions of target value, right? And correlations between the columns. These all data, this is the analysis of the data, means what you upload, you can see the data here, you can analyze the data here. Okay, so this is the analysis of the data, and this is the real time, and it's coming from that data set, right? This is the files report. Again, this is the predictions, right? This is the last thing. Predictions here, you need to enter the value, means you will have the full, means data, what is the age, gender, all things, right? You can enter the data here, and after that, according to that data, system will predict according to multiple algorithms that you are suffered from heart disease or not, right? And the majority, if algorithm, there are six algorithms, right? So if the majority is saying that you are suffered from heart disease, then you are suffered from heart disease, right? If majority is saying you are not suffered, then you are not suffered, right? So let me pick some of the data from my previous records. So this is the age I am predicting is for the 63. His gender is male, chest type is equal to this one, and what is the blood chest pain, 145 233 10, and after that 150 2.300. Sorry, what was that? 150, right? 150 2.3, and then 001. It will be the 0 at 0 and 1, and so this data I have entered, right? So once you click on the check and show the results, then it will show you the result, right? So you can see Okay, there are different algorithms, right? This is the accuracy, right? And this is the result, right? So this is the prediction, right? Three algorithms is saying that you are not suffered, and three algorithms are saying that you are suffered, right? And even so, this is the accuracy score, right? Accuracy score. And then after that, these values you have entered, I have entered some of the wrong values on which the system is not predicting the correct things, right? I will show you in the next day. And this is the graph, right? So these six algorithms I am using, I think there are five here, right? So okay, yeah, so there will be six algorithms, right? And what are those? Decision tree, I think there is some decision tree is not here, right? So I will add the decision tree here also, right, in the graph, right? So you can see the algorithm is showing this data. Okay, what I'm doing now, okay, I'm entering the correct value again. So I'm checking, so 63 male, so 63 male and chest pain is equal to 3, so 3 means this third number records. And then after that, 145 233 1 145 233 1, and after that 0 150 0 0 150, this will be the 0, right? And 0 2.3001 2.3 2.3 0 0, right? And this is the 1, right? And once you click on the check and show result, so this okay, so you can see now the majority of the algorithm is saying that you are suffered from the heart disease, right? But so what I have done, right, I have chosen the first row of the data with the target value 1, right? So only the nav base is saying that it's not suffered, but majority of algorithm is saying that you are suffered, right? So this project, and this is the graph for that, right? So there is only five graph value. So 1 2 3 4 5, yes, decision tree is missing here. I will add that decision tree also, which is saying that it's 81.95%, 97%, right? Okay, so this is the predictions, right? And then after that, my account, from where you will be able to update your account details. This is the account, and you can upload the picture, you can update the account details. This is a change password. I already explained you the change, the functionality, and log out. So this above menu is totally session driven, and if you log out from the system, the session will be destroyed and you will not be able to access the internal menus, right? So once you click on the logout, then you can see none of the administration menu, it just pings because it's a session driven. But if you log in, then you will be able to get the menus there, right? So this all functionalities I have developed inside this project, and I have implemented six algorithm in this project, right? So if you need more functionality, if you need more enhancement in this project, just put it into the comment. I will incorporate those changes. I will make this project more better and better according to your requirements. And don't forget to subscribe our channel for getting the latest project videos on the latest technologies. Thanks for watching the video. Thank you very much.